just telling you something that doesn't have nothing to do with the loving that we're in. Baby, I hear she saying this game we're playing should be complicated. If you want, I said I think she's crazy. Cause love don't have to be a bunch of drama, bunch of knockdown drag outs, crying in the rain. It's alright to keep it light now, mama, don't you think? We're having such a good time together, and it's only just begun. My heart's never smiled so hard, baby. Loving you is fun. It's fun. I'm walking around all over this town, 10 feet off the ground, so happy I found you, baby. I love it. There's no self-help book on your shelf. You know too well they're trying to sell you something for nothing. Cause love don't have to be a bunch of drama, bunch of knockdown dragouts, crying in the rain. It's alright to keep it light now, mama, don't you think? We're having such a good time together, and it's only just begun. My heart's never smiled so hard, baby. Loving you is fun.
Okay, so we first met at an open mic at HD Records. She was down with, playing with Eric's dad, Bob. We were down there. I was down there with our old drummer, Jared. And we watched more like this chick's pretty good, actually. And so that was the first time we met officially. She came and she auditioned for the band. And I was like, all right, we got a problem here. This chick's pretty cute. No, it all worked out. And she, you know, obviously joined the band, and then magic happened from there.
The first time we met was at HD Rockers, a bar in Maple Park, where he's from. And I was playing in a band with one of his best friends, Eric Wicklund's father, Bob. And so we were doing like a little open mic thing, Bob and I were, and then I met Kyle because he was playing the same night. So that was like the first time I officially met him. And then I had joined the band, I think like a month or two later. And then that's when we like really started hanging out a lot more, and I thought he was a big dork, still do, but...
I proposed to Courtney down in Nashville. That's her favorite place in the world. Originally, I was going to do it in Gatlinburg, Tennessee, but she changed the plans, so we went to Nashville. We were going to go to Nashville the whole time, but I was going to propose in the mountains. So I had her whole family there, convinced her to do a river walk because we had friends there that had never been to Nashville, so we were going to do the river walk. But it was raining, and she could not figure out why the heck we wanted to do this river walk when it was raining. We got her to go down there and got out by the river and the bridges and the stadium, and proposed right there, and then her family came running out. It was perfect. I nailed it.
Kyle proposed in Nashville, and he totally surprised me and had, well, we were down there for a friends trip that we take every year, and then he had surprised me with my parents, my brother, my grandparents, and then his parents. All were like hiding, and then it was like pouring down rain right when he was gonna do it. So they were saying they wanted to do this river walk, and I was like not having it. So I was like, I'm just gonna stay up here and go to one of the bars, and you guys can go. And they're like, no, like come down. So they had to like keep persuading me to get down there. And so finally, like we walked down, he had to do it like right away because it started raining a lot then. And so then I turned and like all our family was there, and I was like, what? So it was quite the surprise.
Courtney, Kyle, you come as individuals today, but you leave as husband and wife. You gain new family members, and you probably have to make some new choices, rearrange some of your thinking. But one thing that I don't think will change is your love for music. Music seems to be the thing that the Lord has used to bring the two of you together. Your music journey has taken you to the band that you both now sing in. Seems like it was just about 4 years ago that your Nana and I traveled down to a little honky-tonk in Nashville, Tennessee, right outside Nashville. Remember that?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. And you'd been singing a song for a while. That song, If I Didn't Have You. Remember that? But that's one of those songs that every time you sang it, you had to look at each other, right? Your eyes met. And I can remember being down at that honky-tonk. You started to sing that song. Nana leaned over to me, and she says, I think there's some chemistry going on up there.
Definitely what I love most about Kyle would be his, just kind of his ability to see others in a way that nobody else does. He's really patient with people. He has a kind heart. So definitely what I love most about him and his sense of humor. I mean, we can just entertain each other all day long with stupid jokes that aren't funny to anybody else.
What do I love most about Courtney? She's pretty spontaneous. We can have a day off on Friday night, and she'll just all of a sudden be like, we should go to Milwaukee, or we should drive down to Nashville for the weekend. I love it because Courtney always keeps you on your toes.
Courtney, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
Courtney, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
And with all that I am and all that I have,
with all that I am and all that I have,
I honor you in the name of the Father.
I honor you in the name of the Father,
the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Son and the Holy Spirit.
Kyle, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
Kyle, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
And with all that I am and all that I have,
with all that I am and all that I have,
I honor you in the name of the Father.
I honor you in the name of the Father,
the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Son and the Holy Spirit.
First kiss? I think it was at Bootleggers in Maple Park.
No, it was not Bootleggers. We were at Bootleggers right before that. But no, technically the first kiss was not at Bootleggers, so he is wrong. Our first kiss was actually at his old house when he lived with his roommate. But yeah, so that was like our technical first kiss was just back at his house.
It was magical.
Thank you.
Mr. and Mrs. Kyle Miller.
You love me, say we'll always work it out. I know it's kind of scary, but it's only temporary doubt.
And we decided we really couldn't afford that wedding planner per se. So my wife took the ball and said, "Yeah, I can do that." And it didn't take long to figure out that we couldn't afford to have her be the wedding planner. To Kyle McCourtney.
Jake has been asking for the last few months if he could be the best man, and Kyle told him that if I were to get sick or couldn't come, that Jake would step in and do this. So if you want to step in for the best man right now, I think the speech would be awesome.
Courtney, I always could be your best friend. I always will be. I want to say, I'm glad you didn't puke. Oh. Courtney, always gonna be my sister-in-law. Oh. And Kyle, my brother-in-law too. Kyle is part of my friend. I said at his house, I told Kyle that he don't need me anymore, but he does. But I'm afraid that Courtney is gonna be his bestie. I am very happy for Kyle Courtney. Cheers for Kyle Courtney.
I'm Adam, Kyle's younger brother. We gotta clarify that I'm younger, because I've been mistaken our entire life for me being his older brother. So, as you guys heard, Kyle and Courtney took a trip to Nashville for Kyle proposed to her. I couldn't go, but Kyle called me shortly after and asked if I'd be his best man. First day to tell me that she said yes. We weren't all positive she was gonna lower her standards. So Kyle asked me if I'd be his best man, which honestly I thought was a huge honor at first until I saw my competition. And it was a no-brainer, besides Jake just knocked it out of the park. But
I just figured I'd kind of give you all an idea what it was like growing up with Kyle. Kyle was always older than me, so he was always in charge of me when mom and dad weren't there. We'd get off the bus when mom and dad were still at work, go home, and it consisted of Kyle and the neighbor kid making me dress up in all my winter gear, run around in the backyard so they could hang out his bedroom window and shoot me with paintball guns. it didn't take too long, and I hit puberty. Kyle didn't.
Okay.
So the picking on me and fighting slowly came to a halt. But no, I just want to come up here, say welcome to the family. We couldn't be more happy for you guys.
Knowing Courtney as long as I have, I've seen her and Kyle's relationship from the beginning. And on multiple occasions, she's told me that one of the greatest things about her and Kyle's relationship is how they are each other's best friend. To Kyle and Courtney.
I know it's kind of scary, but it's only temporary doubt. I've done a lot of stupid things, but promise that you're gonna stay long enough to grow old with me. We're gonna see the good times, love each other through the bad. Gonna hurt like hell when we lose our moms and dads. So let my shoulder hold your tears. Oh,